6.2. In our last class, we had discussed till question number 3. Let's continue question number 4. Here is the figure drawn here. In this figure, it is given that PQ is parallel to SC and the value of angle PQR is 110. The value of angle RST is 130 degrees. What you have to find? You have to find the angle QRS. Let's find where the angle QRS is forming. QRS is formed here. This is your QRS. Right? Now, looking at the figure, we are not getting any corresponding angle, alternate angle, co-interior angle, nothing. We are not getting anything because the point where we have to find the angle is not lying on a parallel line. Right? There is no parallel line drawn from R. So we cannot relate these two lines with point R. So for this, whenever question like this comes, you will just draw a parallel line through the point given. Just draw a line which is parallel to the given two lines. So let's name it AB, which is passing through R. What I have done? I have drawn a line which is parallel to PQ and ST and is passing through R. So, construction. What you have constructed? You will write in this point. Construction. Draw AB parallel to PQ and ST passing through R. Point R से पास होती हुई एक लाइन ड्रॉ की है, this is our construction, and which is passing through R and is parallel to the two lines PQ and ST. Okay, so this PQ and ST are parallel, and if I draw AB parallel to PQ, then automatically AB will be parallel to ST because we have read a theorem that if two lines are parallel to a common line, then the three lines are parallel to each other. So we have done our construction. Now, let's see. Now, AB is parallel to SP, or you can say AR is parallel to SP by our construction, since we have written AB is parallel to PQ and AB is parallel to ST also. So, since AB is parallel to SP, since AB is parallel to SP and SR is a transversal. SR is a transversal. Since SR is a transversal, then the two angles, this one and this complete one, are what? Are alternate interior angles, right? So you write angle TSR equals to angle SRA. Reason is alternate interior angles. Now, what is the value of PSR? It equals to 130 degrees. So write the value of PSR equals to 30 degree equals to SRA. Let's see what is SRA. SRA is formed by two lines, two angles. First one is this one, SRQ, and the second one is QRA. That means this angle SRA have two parts. First one is this and the second one is this. First one's name is SRQ, so write angle SRQ plus. The second one is QRA. Write down QRA. Since in our question, the angle's name is RS, QRS, so let's name it QRS. QRS. I have started earlier from S. Now I am starting from Q. Angle is same. QRS. Now, you know the value of QRA? No. Till now, we doesn't know the value of QRA or QRS. So let's make it equation 1 and leave it from this point, at this point. Now, moving forward. By construction, PQ is parallel to AB. Again, by construction, the way we have constructed, AB is parallel to PQ and line QR is a transversal. Okay? QR is a transversal. So, These two angles again are what? Alternate angles. Or if we doesn't know what the value of this one, we can say, let's remove all these lines. We can say that these two are forming what? Co-interior angles. The two angles are forming co-interior angles because we know angles formed on the same side of a transversal are co-interior angles. So you'll say PQR and QRA are co-interior angles. If they are co-interior, their sum is 180 degrees. So you'll write angle PQR plus angle QRA both equals to 180 degrees. Okay? Because reason is co-interior angles. Right? Let's put the value of PQR. It equals to 110. 110 degrees plus angle QRA equals to 180. So angle QRA equals to 180 minus 110. You got the value of angle QRA equals to what? 70 degrees. You got the value of QRA. What you have to do? You just need to put this value of QRA in equation 1. Let's put the value of QRA in equation 1. So I'm writing it over here. Putting value of angle QRA in equation 1. Okay? So 130 degree equals to angle QRS plus 70 degrees. Because the value of QRA is 70. Now, 130 degrees, this 70 will come this side. And minus 70 equals to QRS. So you got the value angle QRS equals to what? 120 minus 70 equals to 60 degrees. So you got your answer. QRS equals to 60 degrees. So whenever this kind of question comes, you get a point which is not lying on a parallel line. Just make a construction, draw a line parallel to the other given lines passing through the given point. Okay? I hope this much is clear to you all. Let's move on to the next question. Their names are AB and CD. And now, there are three points here, P, Q, and R. This equals to 127 degrees. This one is of 50 degrees. This is your X and this one is your Y. Okay? This much is given in your textbook. Now, what you have to do is find the value of X and Y. AB is parallel to CD. This much is given. And these two angles value. Okay? Let's start our solution. Okay. You can clearly see that AB is parallel to CD and PR is the transversal. Why I have written PR? Because AB and CD are parallel, this one is a transversal. So the pair of angles formed here and here are at alternate interior position. That means their values are equal. So you will write angle APR equals to angle PRD. The reason is alternate interior angles. Right? We have found alternate interior angles. What are they? APR, that means this complete angle, and PRD, that means this angle. APR consists of two angles. One is of 50 degree and the second one is Y. So write 50 degree plus Y. Because adding these two, you will get APR. Angle APR, two angles are milkar bana hai, jispe ek 50 degree ka hai and the second one is Y. So write that 50 plus Y here. Now, angle PRD, the value of angle PRD is given 127 degrees. Put that value here. Now you get the value of y equals to 127 degree minus 50 degree equals to 77 degree. So the value of y is 77 degree. You got this answer? Now what next? What next we'll do? Since AB and CD are parallel, PQ is a transversal, and clearly 50 degree angle and X are at what? Alternate position. So you simply write, since AB is parallel to CD and PQ is a transversal, then angle APQ equals to angle QPQR. Angle APQ, that is this angle, equals to angle PQR, this angle. Angle value of APQ is 50 degree and value of PQR is X. We got the value of X equals to 50 degree. And the reason here was alternate interior angle, right? So you got the value of X and Y. X equals to 50 degree and Y equals to 77 degree. This much you need to prove, you need to get in this question. So I am summing up my class over here. I have solved till question number 5, and question number 6 is left. You will solve it by your own. And do maintain your notebook, do complete your notebook. Whenever the school reopens, it will be checked. Okay, students? Thank you.